Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to our blog. Bill and I are doing this little documenting our journey, and it's a series on how to get out of body. And it's been a long time since I've been really working at getting out of body, and it's I was never a natural, and hell, I don't even want to fucking do it anymore. So we decided to test our stuff and do our stuff on it. So she's going to be giving me release sessions and maybe soul contract sessions. Maybe we don't know what we're going to do. We're going to document it. So I also want to share that our journey and what we're doing, how we're doing it, in hopes that people will get something out of it. And just by watching our videos, learn some tips and tricks on getting out of body and improve their ability and willingness to get out and using the techniques or strategies that we're sharing here. So hopefully it'll be a really great series. And Gary V says, document your journey. Don't worry about quality content or anything like that. Just turn on the freaking camera and record your journey. So this is our journey, and it's not really like, you know, professional videos, teachings or lessons or anything. And I go, well, okay. So one of my issues in this regard is, sometimes I'm a little concerned about what people will think about my videos. So that kind of would slow me down in documenting our journey about me getting out of body and you helping me with my issues and stuff like that. So I'd like to start with that issue. If it's okay, coach.
Sure. Okay, so tell me something about sometimes being concerned about what people will think about your videos.
Well, I've always been a case like that. I'm always concerned about what people think. It's like, I hate that about myself. And these great gurus, hey, don't give a shit about what people fucking think about anything. God, I wish I could be there. But I feel like I'm a little bit more, isn't that moving in the direction of a sociopath or something? It's like I cling to, okay, did I ever do all right? I got to look at other people and say, you see if I'm a stable human being or some shit. Anyway, so sometimes I can make a video and I don't give a shit. I can just upload it. But here we are, we're going to make videos about Ubi stuff. And I made lots and lots of videos about getting out of body because I used to get out lots and lots. And now I don't get out so much. And it's like the shame. What's wrong with you, Rich? I know. Fuck. So there's lots of, that's just one reason I get a little concerned about what people think about my videos. I'm using the fucking F word. Goddamn fucking word. What the fuck? What the fuck that come from? So yeah, I get a little concerned. And I want to make some good videos, I mean, good content that will help people with their get out of body journey or astral travel, soul travel, consciousness shifting to other realms, all that stuff. Because you can learn a lot. I've learned a fucking lot. It's great. And I helped you get your shit back together and getting out of body. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I would like to do that, but I get impaired or limited because of my little concern sometimes about what people will think about my videos.
Okay. Now, are there any other reasons why you're sometimes being concerned about what other people will think about your videos?
No, I think that's about it.
Okay. So when was one of the first times when you were sometimes being concerned about what other people will think about your videos?
The first video I ever made, uploaded on YouTube, it was about Ubis. The very first, I've uploaded over 1,000 videos in the last 7 or 8 years. Most of them got, the first 300 or so got fucking deleted and never returned. But yeah, so anyway, the first video I made, I was a little concerned about what people would think. And it took me like a month to do the video. I had special effects, green screens, animation. I used Sims, the Sims game, like version 2 or something, Sims 2 or something. And I would make I just take screenshots with overlays. So you would have this invisible person's laying on a couch, and then I take that snapshot, and then the next they're standing up or getting up off the couch, and I'd snap that and snap that and all that. And I'd have a little like you, you're the Ubi guide, so to speak, Ubi coach. And I had this, so I had this other person in a chair next to, it was fucking great. Took over a fucking month for my first video on YouTube because I was a little concerned about what people would think. And then I was so scared. I was like fucking weird scared, you know, like paranoia scared. And the very first comment I got, and it was just about getting out of body and the guided method where you can talk somebody out. You know, they can just sit down and relax and you can give them a it's kind of like a hypnosis session, but it's not hypnosis. It's something better. And it's a guided, it's more like a guided visualization. And with some people with the right talents and skills, visual skills, I can literally talk them out of their fucking bodies. It's like uncanny, weird shit, but it's just something I could do. And I knew the tips and the tricks and what it's all about, consciousness shifting. So anyway, I made a video on all that. And the very first comment I got, I think the guy's name was something like FBI 666 or some fucking thing like that. Scared the fuck out of me. It's like, oh, you know, I don't know if the 666 was really, the FBI part was, and then some numbers. And that was this guy's handle, you know. I'm Rich 2150X. This guy was FBI with three fucking numbers. I'm like, the fuck? I don't want the FBI fucking eye looking at my shit on YouTube. Are you kidding? So, yeah. I never really thought of it like that. But, you know, that could be a good place for a starter if you needed to. Where? How did this situation start? Well, I don't know. Being a little concerned about what people, being a little concerned about what the fucking FBI thinks. About my videos. Anyway. Yeah.
Okay. So what might sometimes being concerned about what other people think about your videos be keeping you from doing?
Oh, just turning on the fucking camera and talking. Just cranking them out. And most recently, I've been very interested in politics. I mean, not this week. You know, but in the last like 6-8 months, I've been very interested in politics, was staying up with it for a long time until I finally said, oh, fuck this. It's too getting fucking too crazy. But I was very interested in reporting and following the whole Mueller report and all these attacks and all this political stuff. And I wanted to make videos about it. But one, you know, some of my audience could give a shit about that stuff and thinks it's, everybody's a bad guy. And so they don't want to hear that shit. And then what I had to say about it, I was pretty sure YouTube and Google and the other social media sites would not like what I had to say about this stuff. And then I started sensing and feeling that I'm getting shadow banned. And I stopped getting from 1,500 views every day, whether I make a video or not, because I have about 1,000 videos up. It went from 1,500 down to 300. And it gradually went up to 400, but it's like a struggle. Boom, 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 boom. And it's like, fuck, I'm being shadow banned, blocked, all kinds of shit. I'm not losing the subscribers, but nobody's watching. And I go, well, maybe it's time I get a little concerned about what people think about my videos, including Google and YouTube. So, yeah. And here I am. I'm just trying to get a session here to get cleared up so I can talk about Ubis, getting out of body, and how do I present? You know, I look like a dick. You know, this is not the professional. Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog and a couple of good laughs and jokes. You know, this is the that other me. Hi, I'd like to introduce you to the other me.
Okay. So what might sometimes being concerned about what other people think about your videos be a substitute for?
Not giving a shit. Hey, fuck you. This is my video. You don't like it? Don't fucking watch. You don't like it? Unsubscribe. Like that matters anymore. I get a few hundred views on my videos. You don't need subscribers to get that many fucking videos. I'm not saying I don't appreciate all my subscribers. I'm just saying, what the fuck happened with the YouTube and all that shit where people aren't watching them anymore? I think it's like shadow banned for all that shit I've been given, the deep state and Khazarian mafia, Clinton. I made some wisecracks about what's that? That bitch that was bashing Kavanaugh, you know, a fucking FBI fucking plant. That's just disgusting shit. So you bring that stuff up, you know, and you don't have, it doesn't have to be in the titles of the tag or the description. Those fucking algorithms, that technology hears every fucking word you speak. So I just fucked this video in the ass. Saying the words FBI and the blonde, what is her name? Ford or whatever the last, anyway. Yeah, I'm a little concerned about what people think. I'm not really, you know what? It's not so much, well, yeah, I am concerned about what people will think, and I'm also concerned about what YouTube will fucking think. You know, now we got AI thinking now, and we're worried about what the AI is thinking. What's that AI thinking? It's thinking it's going to shadow ban your fucking ass. That's what it's thinking. That's true. If it's funny, it's probably true. This is where I got this shit from. That's probably fucking true. And that's funnier than hell. So, yeah. Okay, I'm a little lightheaded on that one. That's probably a good place to take a break on this one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Break then.
Okay. Thank you. And this is how the release work technique works. It's really you get someone who is a good and willing listener. They're safe to talk to. And you can spill your guts and feel safe doing so. And it helps you, the questions themselves help you get in touch with your stuff and talk it out. It's catharsis. It's anybody and everybody has done it with a good best friend, you know. So best friend for hire, you know. Well, BBF for money, you know. That's fucked up. Hey, you got to start somewhere. So thank you. You're helping me with getting more free and comfortable talking on video, on camera, even after 800,000 videos, right? Still helps. And I'm glad because I want to talk about the Ubi stuff. That's what I really want to share and talk about. We'll get back into that more specifically as we document our journey here.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. Really appreciate you. And thank you guys for watching. And like, share, and subscribe over and over and over and over again, because they block and they cancel and they delete and they do all kinds of creepy shit. And we know who they are. Oh, yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Bye now. Bye now.
Bye.
Oh, thank you. Okay.